like change. But no, some real shit though. Like everybody in Shut here up. Dream chasers. You know what I'm saying? And I just want to say, I like your flow, and I'm introducing some people and shit, and help it grow. But you always remember to chase that dream. You still young, but youth is never an excuse for anything or a crutch for anything. You won't always be young. It just seemed like yesterday I was your age, man. You know what I'm saying? Just living. Like I wasn't even living with legit dreams. I was just getting up every day because God woke me up.
It's crazy, you know what I'm saying? Because when you're that age, you think you got all the time in the world. But to be honest with you, you're 19. Yeah, you're young. But you blink.
Right.
You'll be 40.
You're going to be sitting around with, you going to be sitting around with, you going to sit around with a mohawk with some curl like the Vader.
This shit go by fast.
So quick.
Yeah, yeah. But like you, like you seem like you got a level head on your shoulder, man, to where, like, I don't know, you probably stole a car, came up here. You know what I'm saying? I don't know. I think about it, I don't know this nigga. He probably stole a car. I gotta get to the studio. You know what I'm saying? But you seem like you got a level head, man. Don't let the illusion of belonging fuck with you. Like, if it's something that's opposed to what you feel in your soul, don't fuck with it. Because when you do that, that's when you become a slave. When you succumb to somebody else's fucking, what they determine is success. Like, if you just... Like, I just now realized that saying, I don't want a job, is some cool shit to say. Because I was always raised, I don't want no job. You just lazy. One kind of person don't want to work. Nobody wants to work. We want money. We want the benefits of working. That's why you try to get something that don't feel like work when you're doing something that you want to do.
Yeah,
but people, we so fucking trained to think that 9 to 5, matter of fact, it's on the evils. Jay-Z say, they say 9 to 5 is how you survive, but I ain't trying to survive. I'm trying to live it to the limit and love it a lot. You know what I'm saying? Who in the fuck is trying to survive?
Right.
Life is bad enough to where you shouldn't be. You get a fucking check, and you already got a fucking list of shit you got to pay, and you get through paying all that bullshit, and you got enough money to get back to work the next week.
Right.
And get some fucking Lunchables. You know what I'm saying? You got gas money and Lunchable money, you know what I'm saying? Where
no
you can't do shit.
No Lunchable.
Should no grown man ever have to, if you ever see me eating a Lunchable, I'm not two more Lunchables away from suicide. I'm like, if I have to eat some more cheese and crackers, I'll kill myself.
I take it hard now. Well, you two more Lunchables away from shooting up the job.
Mm-mm.
You know how hard it is?
Because they ain't did it to me.
No,
I did it myself.
But you know how hard it is to eat a Lunchable? Because you think about it. You got a 30-minute lunch break. Everybody else got legitimate Ready-made, lunches. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? You watching them eat. And when you eat a Lunchable, a grown man can eat a Lunchable in one bite, but you got to stretch that shit out for 30 minutes. So you nibbling.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
if I
just make sure I chew it all.
You nibble. You take little bites, but you chew big.
And then you be half a fag sucking the cheese before you swallow it.
Then the conversation you have while eating just make you feel like somebody said, oh, what you eating? Oh, I'm eating a Lunchable.
Watch my figure.
It's full of riboflavin. Oh, for real? Then the conversation you have me, you get done with me. Oh, man, I need one of them. Oh, you want some? No grown man want to share no Lunchable.
Hell no,
especially not the cheese, because it's all stuck together.
You know, it's fucked
up. They got to dig to get the cheese out.
Yeah.
But say they only take cheese and cracker. Now the proportion is off, so you got 13 meats left.
How in the fuck they gave me 7 cheeses?
Now you mad.
You can't go back into work and shit. Your stomach growling. And then they give you that brick hard cookie.
Then you call
the brick hard cookie for dessert.
Then you call in. You like, y'all shorted me a piece of cheese.
Yeah.
Then they FedEx it to you in this big ass box with the ice.
Hey, I ain't trying to be, you know what I'm saying? I ain't trying to give y'all a hard time or nothing. But Monday at work, I was really hungry and y'all came up short on a piece of cheese. And I was just wondering, like, can I get all my money back? Good. You know what I'm saying?
Well, sir, we'll send you a piece of cheese.
Ma'am, I don't take shorts.
Do you have the...
Ma'am, I don't take shorts.
Do you have the lot number?
Ma'am, I don't take shorts. I don't take shorts.
You have the lot number, sir?
I threw it in the trash at work, ma'am, and they collect trash from Tuesday.
That's
right. Hey, that's how it is, man. You become analytical about bullshit and create a fucked up atmosphere. You don't like people, you know what I'm saying? You don't want to pay your friends back money you own. Break up the friendship. Hey, man, I only got $100 this week. You only borrowed 50. You borrowed 100. You didn't borrow it in increments. You know what I'm saying? I was fucking up friendships and shit. Hey, but like I was saying, though, just do you. Like, people, when you got a talent or a vision or a dream, you see it more clear than everybody else. like they won't be able to see, like you describe it, it's like some good pussy. That's what a dream is. If it's your bitch, you fucking her. You're like, this is some incredible pussy. And you're like, man, I hit this chick the other day, man, her pussy was, and then you realize, I can't explain how the fuck that shit felt. And you think, well, maybe because it's just for me. It's for my vision, you know what I'm saying? That's your pussy, that's your vision. You know what I'm saying? Everybody won't see it how you see it. You know what I'm saying? And it's going to be roll, you know what I'm saying, bumpy roll. You hit this, hit that, you're going to want to quit. You're going to give up. I don't know, you know what kind of drugs y'all sell. Y'all be selling, you want to sell pills. You want to go cook some meth. I don't know what the kids do these days. It was crack when I was growing up. It was crack and marijuana. I don't know. Maybe y'all selling Jordans and shit. You know what I'm saying? I got some Jordan shoestrings for the low. You're going to want to quit, man, but just don't quit. You know what I'm saying? Because you ain't got talent for nothing. When God bless you with a talent, he give you the talent, then it's up to you what you do with it. God ain't no person who gonna grab you and just move you around and shit like you a toy or you a piece on a Monopoly board. That's where your free will. He give you the tools, and then it's up to you what kind of house you build. Or even if you just don't live in a house. We all got these tools and these resources. You know what I'm saying? Where we are capable of doing things. Like, I could be in a position where I don't work for nobody, but I didn't start using my resources, my tools till late. And part of that reason is just me not knowing how to and nobody showing me how to. But they was there. You know what I'm saying? Even if I didn't ever recognize that they was there. When I think about it, I'm like, I could have been and started doing some of this shit. And you young enough to know now where somebody can tell you, you got the tools, build your house. Build how many rooms you want on it, how many bathrooms. It's like a blank fucking page. Like when you writing your rhymes or typing your rhymes, think about that's how you building your dream. You saying whatever you want to say on that paper, and that's how you dictate your life. You know what I'm saying? So just keep grinding, man. You're going to be cool and shit. Just knock it out. But I'm going to ask you, anything you want to say and shit? Like what you can do, I can find you on Facebook. You can end up sharing this link, tell you people, hey, I was on BET. They won't know no difference because black people stupid. Black people, we got so much going on and shit. Be like, hey, man, I was on TV. Y'all see that gorilla? I was dragging that baby. And they're like, you was on TV? No, I'm talking about the gorilla, but if you go to this link, you hear me on BET. You know what I'm saying? You got to say a bunch of shit at one time. You know what I'm saying? Man, Serena got a fat old ass. And then we was at the studio, and then the girl was in there with the goofy hat on. I don't know where she got it. It had rhinestones and shit. And you know what I'm saying? They're going to be like confused. They're going to think BET play. So you can share this. Let them know you was on here or whatever. So just for the people who do know you and the people who get to know you, is there anything you want to say?
Man, I'm about to put the city on the map. Just watch, give me some time. I'm about to get us all out of here, you feel me?
He gonna get all y'all out of here. One at a time. This nigga built Noah's Ark. You will not drown no more, niggas. You will not drown no more. Hey, what's up? It's been another edition of the show. Anything you wanna say, Bowen passing? You been over there typing and shit. What she say? She gonna suck it.
She thought about it, but she turned down off of something I said earlier.
Quit her, bitch.
Yeah.
Damn. Go ahead.
Basically great show again today. Make sure y'all, if y'all not doing nothing on the 19th at the Paramount, they having an event. I'm going to get some more
Anderson.
I'm going to get some more information because I don't know if they got openings for people to come out. You got a talent. I don't know if it's like a talent show or what, but I know here shortly. And just keep in touch with people out there because God is good all the time.
All the time.
God is good.
Except on Saturdays and Wednesdays when he ain't giving you winning Powerball tickets. On Wednesdays and Saturdays, he don't give a fuck. At least according to my history. God ain't never paid attention to me on a Wednesday. It's Saturday.
We gonna skip.
She don't even fucking count.
Her right here.
She don't even fucking count.
I'm a clutch.
What up? Shout out to Clutch, man. You want to say something?
Shout out to me, the Clutch, Candy. I'll see y'all later.
She's so fucking dull. Yeah. Like, I bet that's how she sucked dick, like, once.
Dull.
She was like, I'm going to suck 8 times, and I'm through. I ain't put no effort in this.
And count them. One.
You ever got some head where you feel like a
two.
Like, she had a number in her head. Yeah.
I'm like, you know what? Stop. Just stop.
Yeah, you just hurting everybody in here.
Stop.
Hurtful.
three.
It's painful to feel like you've been counting. I'm going to get six sacks. I'm out of here.
Then you get mad, though, because you only going to give me seven. What kind of number is seven? Who the fuck picked seven as a random number?
This bitch thinks she got it. This bitch thinks she going to create the world and rest on a day. Seven. Trying to give me a week.
And the fifth one wasn't even all the way down. It was weak. The fourth one was dry. The third one, she used teeth.
Yeah, with teeth.
Damn, with the teeth.
That's what I'm saying, man. Ain't no real bitch use no teeth. That's what I'm saying. If you a real bitch, you ain't ever put your teeth on no dick.
Ever.
That's how I feel. And I'm not a real bitch, but every real bitch, y'all know, they rather you knock their teeth out then. Yeah, man, am I ready now?
Damn.
It's another edition of the show, man. We had a good time. Shout out to EXO. That fucking goofy, nappy, itchy afro. That shit.
Man, that shit look like, hey, her afro. He ain't even wearing it and he know it itches.
Hey, my ear start itching. Hey, your afro look like fucking ball hair. It look like urban ball hair.
It's beautiful.
It's probably soft though, man, because that shit deceptive, man. That shit look like, hey, that shit look like a bad neighborhood. Like if you wouldn't touch, you'd be like, I wouldn't walk through the neighborhood. Like, I wouldn't touch that shit. But anyway, we miss you, though. We'll see you next week. We can't wait to get you back. I'm sure you got some fantastically boring stories. EXO, that's my other, that's my co-host. She's usually here, and you would have had a hell of a time with her because she's silly. She a good co-host and shit, but unfortunately, we had to go with Plan B. Like, we want to try and get pregnant, so we bring a Plan B.
She in the morning after.
Hey, yeah, it's morning after. Hey, last minute. Hey, I ran out of gas. Can I use your car to go to the store? At midnight? Yes, at midnight. You go get your car, go get you another bitch.
What are you doing? I'm about to have surgery because I've been having this sharp pain on my side. Well, we need you at the show. Okay, I'll come.
Yeah, put that show on hold. That's what she clutch.
Never again, y'all.
You a lie. She our shooter. She
fucked up.
She a lie. She enjoyed herself.
Like shit.
Yeah, with them motherfucking milk filled titties. Anyway, fantastic show, man. I thank everybody. Shout out to K2K1 coming out. Don't forget they got the fight coming up next Saturday at the Horseshoe up in Hammond. It's guaranteed to be a fantastic fight. I'm sure you're gonna knock somebody on the ass. Shout out to what was that nigger name you said? Tayshawn. What was that nigger name you said? That's some nigger shit right there, boy. That's urban.
Shout out to Boomer.
Shout out to Boomer, man. We ain't calling that nigga Tayshawn. Don't call my government name. Call me Boomer. Hey, that's it. Hey, shout out to Boomer, man. Up and coming, young MC. This won't be your last time up here. Like I said, I'm plug you in. Like, we got shows here, Audio Groupie, to where we do it specifically music where people... You can have your music played on the air and things of that nature. So you will be up here again. Introduce you to some people. Shout out to Audio Groupie, Rich Harvest, who turned up last night in that African Haitian club. It smelled like curry, shit, lions, and tigers and bears.
Like spoiled pussy.
It smelled like spoiled African pussy. It smelled like niggas jumped off the boat the last minute and didn't have to come here and be slaves. What up, Suge, though, man? We had another fantastic show, man. I've been thinking about you lately. Marty shared a post. It made me think about you more. Shout out to the three cool cats. We still doing it big. Shout out to, like I said, Rich Harvest, Audio Groupie. Go on Audio Mac, listen to that Backseat Driver. Go on there and listen to that Humble vs. Arrogant. And then make sure you go on SoundCloud and listen to the orangutan. What'd you say this shit called, man? What'd you say this shit called?
Orang related.
Hey, you gotta say it, some niggas, it be embedding their brains. Anyway, though, man, shout out. Remember, if God build it, can't nobody destroy it. Always be true to yourself, and you'll always get to where you want to be. Sometimes, guys just don't give a fuck about you.
And the scene starts to unfold when the man walks through the door with all that gleams and all this gold. Designing names on from head to toe.
Baby.
Here we
baby.
Go.
Baby, slow down a little bit. I just want to get to know you, baby. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to bite your shit. It's all chicken except for the bone. Yeah. Shit, I'm just, hey, I'm getting a little money out here. I just want to spread the wealth, you know what I'm saying? I got money, I got credit cards, I got PayPal cards, whatever you want to do. We can do EBT, you need groceries? Shit, baby, what you looking for?
wild bitches sweat, chill nigga in the sweats. If you don't get no respect, it really don't matter. You could be Louis Vuittoned up, you might as well have on Vine Dutch and Tommy Hill figure with a deck. I don't do dirt, I don't call scenes, I send niggas through to leave a mess. I'm a real nigga in the flesh, I will find a bitch in distress.